Hey guys, good morning. It is Brent Abel here, webtennis.com. Hope you're having a great day so far, wherever you are. 7 a.m. out here on the West Coast, specifically for me, Southern California, the California Desert, Rancho Mirage, 92270, Mission Hills Country Club. And another little romp on the grass with the Big O this morning at around 9:15. Looking forward to that. Looking out at San Jacinto. Looks like another. Gosh darn it, another spectacular day here. So guys, I got a fun story for you this morning anyway, I'll get to it. First things first, in the comments area, what you're going to find is a link that will take you to get registered for this Saturday's immersion, where we've got the great Dr. James Loomis, who was featured in the Game Changers documentary. And we've also got Karen Dugan, who is a plant-based nutritionist. And what's going to happen this Saturday morning, starting at 7 o'clock and 7 o'clock on the West Coast and 10 a.m. On the East Coast, is Dr. Loomis is going to kind of take us through kind of what's the science behind plant-based. Boy, I'm really working the mouth this morning. Unbelievable. He's going to take the science, and it's really compelling, about plant-based eating. I don't preach diet, and I did change my diet big time almost 3 years ago, but I'm not 100% on it. Yeah, a little bit of fish now and then, about 95%. My wife, Mai, is much better. She's about 98%. But, a lot of people have asked me, about my diet, what do I do? And I just say, look, back in February, March of 2018, I changed what I don't eat, right? And that's made a huge difference for me, not only just feeling great, sleeping better, all that kind of stuff, but my results over those 24 months from March of 2018, March of 2020, when we got shut down, the best result I've ever had, far and away, as a tournament player, and then also on the two World Cup teams that I played on 2018, 2019. In Umag, Croatia. So yeah, I do. I mean, I do preach that you ought to really take a hard and honest look at what your diet is and what you're eating. So if you've got any interest in plant-based eating, and again, doesn't have to be perfect, but of making some changes, I would highly recommend you join us this Saturday morning, December 12th, for a live webinar. It's going to be online, and the link to get registered is in the comments area. Small little fee. I think it's under, $39 or something like that. But it's going to be Dr. Loomis for the first hour. And then the second hour is going to be Karen Dugan, and she's going to talk about, you don't have to eat salads all day long for the rest of your life. It's not going to be that. She's going to talk about things that we can eat, how to make them taste great, and it's going to be, lots of different choices. So, guys, that link is in the comments area, and I highly recommend that you join us. If you're thinking about, as I've been talking about lately so much, you got to get the kitchen right. So speaking of getting the kitchen right, this week, I've had a couple of teaching pros join me on my team with my health and fitness business, kind of the work at home, business that I've got. And, which I'm always excited about to get tennis pros, on my team, just because, this trading time for dollars thing. And now where you're only making money as, if you're on the tennis court. And believe me, when I was in Northern California teaching, especially in San Francisco, I mean, there was, dozens or a dozen reasons why I might get canceled that day for either one or more lessons. And the list is pretty lengthy. But look, it's important. If you're a teaching pro, you really ought to consider having a secondary source of income. Got any interest in that? Look, may not be your thing, and that's totally cool. But if you've got some interest, just reach out to me, and I've got a strong recommendation for you. Anyway, so one of the guys who joined me this week, a guy named Mike, teaching pro, and also wants to really up his tennis game in 2021 in his age group. And just, he sort of had this hankering, this kind of thought for a long time that, I really want to, start competing, not now and then and not during just practice matches, kind of getting my, my competitive juices satisfied just during practice sets, practice matches. But I want to get out there, Brent, I want to get out there on the senior thing schedule and see what I can do. And so we had a chat yesterday, and my man, Mike, very transparent, man, I got to lose 16 pounds. And so we started talking about what I do in terms of what I eat and what I don't eat. And we started talking about my training and what I do in terms of what's really helped me training on the court and off the court as well. And one of the things that I've talked about, I don't know, for the last couple of years, and Jeff Jaklich over at Gold Ball Hunting and I did an episode on this, is this phrase that you see right there. Will it make the boat go faster? And will it make the boat go faster is a phrase, is a question that I'm assuming was originated by the British rowing coach it was before the 2000 Sydney Olympics. But the Brits had not done well, right, in the rowing category in the Olympics, and hired this guy. And look, if it's a great story, you ought to go look it up. If you just Google this phrase right here, will it make the boat go faster? And there's a documentary on it. There's a book on it. Anyway, so the short story is this, is that he challenged his guys. He challenged these guys. And I'm going to talk about just one part of it. I'm not getting the whole thing. But one part of it was getting the fellas after they'd spent all day training, and now they're packing up and they're going home. And sort of his parting words to them when they were going back home was, fellas, I know you're going to be, you know, driving home. You'll probably be driving past the pub, and you know that some of your mates are in there after they've been at their jobs. They've been working. They're in there, you know, throwing back a couple of pints. And, you know, it might be kind of fun to go in there and do the same thing. And so the coach says to each one of the guys, if you have that hankering to go in there and hang out with your mates and throw back a few pints, or, you know, you go home and your spouse has got, you know, some kind of a chocolate cake, I don't know, whatever it is, but you got to ask yourself this question. Will it make the boat go faster? If I decide to go in the pub, if I decide to have that little pint of ice cream, will it make the boat go faster? And so whatever the other coaching that he helped these guys with, they became spectacular. The crew became spectacular and they started winning. And it really changed the whole history of the British rowing thing. So look, if you're thinking about next year, 2021, I've got another friend I'm thinking about right now, and a really tough player. He's just entering the 55s next year, and he's had success 20 years ago in the 35s, in the doubles. I'm going to send him the link to this video because he needs to listen to this. Because the same kind of situation is if you are really looking towards next year, and this is assuming of course the tournaments get opened up, is you're going to be faced with lots of decisions along the way as you get ready, as you prepare for next year. And a lot of those decisions will be, hey, you know, you got to ask yourself the question, will this decision that I'm about to make the boat go faster? And there's, you know, if you think about it, there's so many times during the day when we are presented with that kind of situation that you could choose to go with the mates. You could choose to have that dessert. You could choose something else, which could be even like, well, you know what, today I'm just not feeling like I want to go out and kind of do my training to whatever, you know. Well, all those situations require the question, will it make the boat go faster? And I've, you know, lots of times when I'm getting ready for a tournament, I've got a tournament maybe looming 2 months out there, a national event. And there are several times when I've got to ask myself the same question. Hey, man, you really, okay, you guys are going out tonight. Are you really going to have that second beer? or whatever. And I've got to ask myself the question, will this decision make the boat go faster? And so anyway, what I would suggest is you go over to YouTube, I mean, go to Google. Yeah, really. The whole command of the English language this morning is rough. Anyway, go over to Google and just Google this phrase. Will it make the boat go faster? And kind of dig into it a little bit. It's really, you know, it's not a kind of a funny little phrase. It's really a serious kind of a cool thing that I think that assuming that you want to get better at something next year. Hey, look, it might be not just tennis. You know, it might be something else. It might be, hey, I want to lose some weight, right? I want to get rid of, you know, brain fog in the morning, which apparently I've got myself this morning. So I don't know what decision I made last night. Anyway, but you know what I'm talking about. So there you have it, man. Hey, Nicole, good morning. So anyway, that's it for me today. And my buddy Mike, who joined me on my business team this week, really excited for him. You know, not only because he has decided to up his tennis game. And that was one of the things I kind of shoved into his brain yesterday. You got to be asking yourself this question probably all day long until you start to build the habits and you start to feel so much better. He's going to drop 16 pounds and absolutely guaranteed after dropping 16 pounds, maybe in the next 30, 60 days, that question probably won't come up as much, right? Because he's going to feel so much better. So anyway, guys, hope this resonated with you today. As always, I don't know. Yeah, no, I do know for sure. You've got to get out there today and help someone else have a spectacular day. Guys, any questions, any comments, remarks, just go ahead and reach out to me. You can do it through, just leave a comment here. You could also direct message me or just Brent at webtennis.com. And yeah, help someone else have a great day. Guys.